Well, it's a Saturday morning. You know what that means? It's time for the RE/MAX Magnolia Show. I even have a sign. See that? Michelle Cummins, of course, here, the star of the show, and myself, Curtis Pope. Good morning, Michelle.
Good morning, Curtis Pope. How are you?
I am good. How are you doing today?
I'm doing excellente. I have a great view with the RE/MAX balloon. Oh, and yourself, too.
I'm not a good part of the view, no. And for those watching the video, I don't know what's going on with my hair. It's like 2 inches higher than it normally is.
Well, earlier you were saying you were short, so
that's true. So I think take my hair's... I'm just not fighting the curls anymore as I get older. I just don't care.
Well, why should you? Look at it.
I fought
looks
the curls
great.
For most of my life.
You got natural curly hair. You know how many people would, you know, dance for that?
And how often do you straighten your hair?
Too many times.
I've seen you come in with some pretty big hair. Your curls are, I know, you know how I feel, like, exactly, because...
I do the 90s hair really good sometimes. Yeah, I got curly hair today, too.
Without even trying, you've come in with 90s hair. I get it. When you have curly hair, it has a mind of its own sometimes.
Yeah, and you just got to let it be.
Just let it be.
The Beatles song.
And there you go. Yesterday was the anniversary of John
yesterday
Lennon's
too.
Death.
Oh, my gosh,
look
yes.
at you being topical.
Oh, my gosh. And I was right there where it happened, actually, in New York a few years ago when Richard had the audition for the Beatles live theater Broadway play. We went there and we hung out, and that was my first time there at the hotel where he lived. Or what was it called again?
Dakota.
That's it. Yes.
Right by Central Park, right?
Yes. And we took a carriage ride through Central Park. Can you believe it?
Wow.
It was so amazing.
See, I've never been, but for some reason, because I know my Beatles history, I know all this stuff. I don't know why.
And that's the first time I had steak tartare.
And you knew that that was going to come raw and kind of look like hamburger, right?
Yeah. I was a little nervous, very nervous, actually. And but I did it. And
I
was
actually
okay.
had bison tartare one time.
Oh, where at? Montana?
No, it was in like the Okanagan.
Oh, nice.
It was really good, actually.
Was it good?
Yes.
There's a place in Banff where you can get like alligator stuff and like the craziest meats. Craziest. Not me.
Yes,
that's a little too crazy for me.
Of alligators around Banff.
Yeah, no.
I'm a little confused. I've had alligator before. I'll try anything once.
Yeah, there's the place in Agassiz, area district of Kent, that has these really kangaroo burgers, and they have another burger. What is it? But it's really unique burgers.
I don't know if I could eat a kangaroo burger.
I know.
I have this thing about eating cute animals.
I know.
Like, I don't eat veal. I don't eat, I don't eat, like, duck.
Duck confit?
I don't eat.
So good.
I don't eat lamb.
But sad, I know.
I know. I can't eat cute animals. Even... If it wasn't for bacon being so darn tasty, I don't think I'd be able to eat it.
Because pigs are so cute.
Well, especially wink, the baby wink. Ones.
Yeah,
so, yeah.
True. But don't even tell me what they do to horses. No. I don't want to
ever
know.
I'm not going to eat a horse.
Never.
I'm not that
ever.
Hungry.
Yeah. I can't. When I was in Israel at 17, the only other country I've been in, besides obviously the States, but in a little, you know, Mexico. But anyways, I had fish with their eyeballs still looking at me. My dinner was looking at me. I couldn't eat it. And I was starving. Well, not starving. I hadn't ate. I mean, but to me, I was starving.
I hear you. I mean, I don't really want my meal eyeballs. Looking back at me. So
he was looking at me.
Yeah.
This poor thing. No,
well, this
no,
could
no.
be an interesting show. We
can't
should
do
probably
it. Okay, so,
work
okay.
our way back.
Back.
Because we're
on target. Okay. So 1 week ago.
It's like we saw something shiny and off we went.
It's true. So 1 week ago, today, Mission had the amazing downtown parade. And it was so fun, the candlelight parade. And there was so many great floats. And everyone comes out. Everyone's in a good mood. And we at the office at RE/MAX Magnolia decided, oh, what a great day. We just took off the stickers that were on our window, hiding everything. We left, of course, the RE/MAX balloon on it. And it was just like, voila. It was like a great, it was so fun. And we got to see, we're right there downtown front. So we front and center, we got to see everything, and it was a blast. And the winner, so one of our realtors actually judged it as well. She was one of the judges, and the
I've
winner
done that in the past, and it's always been either miserable cold or just pouring rain.
It was really good weather.
Yeah,
actually,
this year it worked out.
It did.
I judged that, I think, 3 times in the past.
You know, when I moved to Mission, I wanted to live like Gilmore Girls. You know, like the TV show. I love that TV show, and I wanted to be Lorelai, living in a Gilmore Girls town. So I moved to Mission, and I'm like, yes, I'm going to live it. And so I was able to walk downtown to the library. I became a member of the Heritage Society and worked there. And I remember going to snow. The first candlelight parade I went to was that year, and it snowed on the parade night, on the candlelight parade. It was so beautiful and so magical. Oh, yeah, it was awesome. But I love downtown. And the winter this year, it was really fun. They did a float, like the Lampoon's Christmas Vacation.
Right.
And the uncle, when he's out with the green tube, you know, and he's like, I don't think he's smoking a cigar.
Yeah.
And, you know, the,
we can't
the
say
shipper.
The line. But I know the line very well that he says there.
The shipper.
Yes, that's sure. That's it. We'll just replace a couple of the consonants there. And yes.
And the company who did it is Dugness Holdings, if I'm saying that correct. They are a service, actually a Mission contractors, and they, you know, obviously do like sewers, septics, all
so
that.
So perfect.
All it's, that it's, fun stuff.
There's a connection there on
there
top
was.
Of
it. It was brilliant. It was so creative. So I'm like, we are going to do a float next year. I don't know what we're going to do, but we got to start spinning our wheels right now and thinking of something very creative.
Well, just go with Todd and Margo when they find that their stereo has been destroyed in that movie, because they know.
Oh, yeah.
Why is the floor wet? I don't know, Margot.
Oh, my gosh. That scene. They do so good in that scene. It's hilarious. Oh, that beautiful.
I love that movie.
Oh, so good. I haven't watched it yet this year, have you?
No, only Christmas movie I've watched, and I'm pushing it so far. I watched Lethal Weapon. It was on TV the other night. It takes place at Christmas. That's
sure.
One of the reasons that Riggs
sure.
is so upset.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
Die Hard's a Christmas
oh,
movie
gosh.
In my world, too. It's about a
no.
man trying to get home with his family on the holidays.
It's everywhere. Like, are you putting Christmas movies in the search field, Christmas or holiday, and that comes up. It's what?
Die Hard is a Christmas movie.
No.
Yes, it is.
Okay.
I will.
You have your
I will die on
this
that. Mountain. It is a Christmas movie.
So very Christmassy, too. On Thursday night, I got to go and to the open house for Mission Hospice Society. They had an open house, and it was so fun to see everyone. Pam Alexis was there, who's been on our show, mm-hmm. and she's doing great work.
Back when she was just the mayor.
Yes. And now look at her. Like, I talked to her about the things that she is really proud that has changed since she's been in office there and what she's working on now. And she's a delight. It was so great visiting with her. And Counselor Jack Gill was there, and he's so awesome. He's such a good guy. He came in on Saturday and saw us at the office, came back. We were making gingerbread houses, realtors making gingerbread houses. It was actually quite funny. And
yeah,
quite
normally you get a contractor to do that.
Yeah. Okay, one of the gingerbread houses, and I won't mention the two realtors that were there working 2x2s. I won't mention the realtors who built it, but the roof was caving in. So the photo I put out on social media and say, judge, which one's your favorite gingerbread? A contractor had said, I hope that one to the far right has insurance because the roof is caving in.
It was Christine, wasn't it? It was
no,
hers.
No.
No?
No.
I just thought it was.
Good gasping.
Yeah, Shania?
No.
Oh, well. It's too easy.
Shania had a Barbie one.
It's too
she did
easy
a Barbie
to say
one.
James. It's too easy to
no,
blame
James
him.
Actually had the Barbie one with Shania.
Of course he did.
It was really cool. Okay, but I won't go on. I won't let you figure it out. But
well,
yeah.
I'm running out of names. It's not going to take too long to figure it out. The people I know there, so.
So something I'm looking forward to this month, talking about Christmas, and it's December, and I'm really excited to do something for the first time that I've done it, and I don't know how many years they've done it, but have you heard of the Mount Lehman Hallmark Christmas movie tour?
I have heard about that. I believe is it new this year, just the last couple of years, where you get to visit a bunch of the places that have been in the Hallmark movies?
I think so. Oh, I think so. A great realtor I know, his house has been used in so many Hallmark Christmas movies specifically. And yeah, there's over 50 movies being represented in these six or so houses that you actually get to walk through. You get to tour through the homes. I'm so excited. I mean, not like I see 1,000 homes. I don't walk through 1,000 homes. But look it, I still love seeing homes. I haven't, 20 years, I haven't stopped loving walking through homes. But, you know, these are Christmas movie homes. So I'm pretty excited about that.
Yeah, Candace Cameron Bure may have very well been in one of these.
Oh, 1,000.
She's in,
probably
she's in
like,
every one of those movies, oh, isn't she?
She's probably in 48 of the ones that we're going to see.
No. Her and then what's the other young lady that, well, she's not that young anymore. She was on Party of Five, and she's the other one. It's not those movies.
Oh yes,
the youngest sister.
Yeah, there's about like five main
Lacey
female
something.
Acts.
I can't remember her last name.
Yeah.
Lacey, something French, I think her last name.
Oh, yes.
But yeah, those two seem to star, they alternate starring in those movies, it would seem.
Yeah, and they do a pretty good job. There's a lady who, I don't know her name. She's one of like the five main gals or whatnot that they use for these movies. And she reminds me, she looks just like Sarah, who was my assistant. I don't know if you remember Sarah.
So. Yeah.
Sarah with an H, and she's awesome. And she's actually... working for the Chilliwack Real Estate Board now because she moved out to Chilliwack and stuff. Anyways, this actress is her doppelganger. I'm like, is Sarah good into acting? Like, that's how close she is. She's so, looks like her. But anyways, okay. So, yeah, I'm really excited about that. And I'm bringing the whole office and we're going to have fun touring the homes. So, yeah, I think if you just Google, if anybody's interested in viewing these homes, it's all Mount Lehman. So just Google Mount Lehman Hallmark Christmas movie tour and you will find their website. And they have raised over $100,000 through the ticket sales only in the last so many few years or whatever they've been doing it. So not very long. And it's going to help people. Well, all the money goes the ticket money goes through for human trafficking. So it's a very good cause.
Well,
much
against
needed.
Human trafficking. Let's you know, when you say for human trafficking.
For against human trafficking.
Against human trafficking.
Thank you for correcting me.
It's just the subtle difference. You know, we're not supporting it.
No.
It's to stop it.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Oh, see, that's why you are the best co-host ever.
Well, I just want people to, you know, I want to be clear on certain things, right?
Yeah. We probably have to go on break and then we'll get back to some of the other hot topics and news, I think, that I have before the stats.
All right. Well, it's probably a good time to remind people where they can go to find all the information that you do have. What's your website?
Always RE/MAX, MagnoliaRealty.com.
We're back with more right after this.